this video, I'm going to show you how you can perform a McNemar test using Minitab. A McNemar test is used when you have nominal data, in other words, they fall into one category or another, and this is categorical, but they are paired. So for example, we have a study where smokers were given an intervention to see if they would then stop smoking. So we have the smoking status of each person, both before and after the intervention. So here we can see this person before the intervention was a non-smoker, and after the intervention they were also a non-smoker. If we scroll down, we can see we do have some non-smokers who after the intervention actually became smokers, but we also have several smokers who after the intervention became non-smokers. So in Minitab, it's easier when you have nominal data to use the actual labels like this, because this is how the results will be displayed and it'll be easier to interpret. When you have a dash T, this means that you have text in the column. If we had entered numerical data, then no longer we would not be able to enter text data. We would not have a dash T. And I just copy and pasted these from an Excel file. So in order to perform your McNemar test, you go to Stat, Tables, Cross Tabulation and Chi-Square, and now here you can choose Other Stats, and now we select the McNemar test. Okay, we then select rows and decide which variable we want as our row. So here I'm going to go for before, select, and then going to click columns, after, select. You can also display percents if that's what you would prefer as well. Okay. And now we have our table here, our cross tabs. So it tells us that the rows are before and that the columns are after. So before the intervention, we have non-smokers, and 20 of these non-smokers remained non-smokers after the intervention, but 5 of them became smokers after the intervention. Of those who were smokers before the intervention, we have 9 who remain smokers afterwards, but 16 who are no longer smokers. And if we then scroll down, we can see here that we have a significant p-value because it is less than 0.05. So this would suggest that the intervention is having a significant impact on smoking status. And you can see that we have the labels of smoker, non-smoker, and before and after because we have these labels here, which is why I suggested putting these in as text rather than ones and zeros.